Hello again. In this video, we'll look at how we use the Customer Journey Map Excel Maker, which is available for free download at this site, Marketing Study Guide, in the link below. So when you open it, it goes to the Information tab and basically says that we want to create this sort of map. And I'll just highlight what's involved in it, but this is all self-populates for you. When you first get to it, it's blank. This is just an image of where we're going. And you'll name your persona. I've just called this guy Bargain Barry. You will describe who they are, and you're allowed to put in five elements of descriptions. And there's drop-down menus all the way through. You go what's important to them. So you list five things that are quite important, and then five things that are not so important or completely unimportant to them. And then we're going to develop their journey. Now, the first phase is their awareness phase, and this is before they've started actively thinking about the product or buying something, but over time they've built an awareness of different brands. So how does that happen beforehand, before somebody's even interested in a product? What are the key elements? And then here, search phase is when they enter the buyer decision process and they are actively looking and seeking information. So what are the main touch points that they're looking at. And once they've done the information search and evaluation, they then go into the purchase decision and what are the steps they go through. So you can see this one actually has arrows. So this is a sequence. And then we look at finally post-purchase, which is our customer satisfaction, loyalty. And we've got five elements we can add and say what happened afterwards. So that's what we're trying to do. So we start with the brand persona. We just click across all of these until we fill it. And they're all drop-down menus. So all you have to do is enter your name. Okay, so I'm just using the name Barry again. And what you do is you pick five descriptors to describe them. And you can add your own down here if you don't like these five. But each of these have a particular drop-down menu. So you click on age, and it gives you an option there. And you'll say they're in their 40s. Occupation may be an important part to them. So they might be an educated worker. They might be quite outgoing. So you pick the ones that are most important. Okay, you can actually turn all these on and play around with them. But once we've decided, we go, okay, these are the five I want to include. And we just go through and set this include in the map as a yes. Now, if we click on too many, what will happen is we'll get a warning and say, hey, only the first five. And as I said before, you can add your own, etc. Then we come down, so this arrow here, and we're going to pick five to include that are very important decision factors. Okay, important factors in the decision. So again, we have a drop-down menu. So we include this one as important. That's unimportant, etc. And we just continue adding ones that we think should be in there. Again, we've got a choice of five to include on the map. Okay, so again, if we enter too many, now we can add our own factors. Okay, so I've got some factors in there. I haven't got all five for the sake of this video. So basically, at this stage, we've set up this column. Okay, so we'll see that populated in the real map at the back. Okay, then we go to the awareness stage. And we go and we pick up to 10 of these touch points. Okay, how do they become aware of a brand beforehand? So, and we're getting categories, we've got advertising, we've got social media and online, etc. Okay, so you just randomly pick them at these stages. And say, oh, yeah, that's possible. I mean, this does not mean they're going to be included, but they're going to be most likely a possibility. So you can then, at the end, you're going to pick more than 10. Just going to go through, as I'm doing here, and say, yeah. So, that's a possibility. And you just keep going through and pick any possibilities. Again, you can add your own. Okay, so we just continue on. We've got the same thing under the search, which is when they first start actually in the purchase decision. We've got the physical purchase and interaction. So you can see the information's up the top here, and then what happens afterwards. So I'm just going to click on a whole bunch of these and pause the video, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, I've just gone through and added yeses and nos all the way through for awareness, search, purchase, and then post sale. What we now need to do is click on fine tune map, and also we selected 12 touch points for awareness, and they're listed there. We've got 14 for search, 11 for usage, and 6. So I've got too many. So what we go and put them in the sequence we want them to appear, and we fine tune the list down to 10. So I'm just going to do this very quickly, so you can see what we're doing. So they're the 10 I want to include. If I accidentally type the same number twice, I'll get a warning. And I just repeat that, so I'll do that for you right now. Okay, I've just now populated my 1 to 10 fields all the way across, except for the last one, which is 1 to 5. And then I have a final map. And everything I've put in and now appears. So I've got my name, my descriptors, my 5 I've got there. I only didn't select 5 of these, but what's important to them, what's not important to them. To copy it, what you do is you drag your cursor over the entire map. All right, and then just go to copy, and then you would paste it to wherever you want. Ideally, you would paste it as a picture, and that way all the formatting is retained, so you can resize it, etc. And of course, you then would repeat this for your next persona, and you develop a whole series of these personas. So the free download's in the link below. Enjoy.